Say a military coup would be in power. How would it be beneficial for it to give power to the civilian government? To a fair government according to true justice. Firstly, it is beneficial if you into any task take a leader or professional who can do it better than you could yourself do. Who is the best for that task? And that is the person who according to justice should be deciding. So the leaders should be chosen according to justice and their decisions followed and similarly about all the other professions that produce the best benefit. And of course that makes sense inside your own group and in the environment that you benefit from. And then it would be most rational for you to, if you could arrange everything so that it is according to the greatest benefit, that you always get the best options. And that is according to justice. So also in relationship to other powers, you should copy what there is good in them, give them position according to justice, and then put them down if there's some characteristic that is not fit to be an example to others. But then, how does this exactly go if say an army makes a military coup and then decides to optimize power benefit, optimize its own forces, the nation toward greatest benefit? So how does one end up then in a really moral government, moral arrangement if one first has the situation that there's somebody in power who ought not to be there? So first one optimizes the system toward justice and then one takes a look at what is it that one wants to benefit, because now the benefit is still going to the army. So what is it that makes the system even better optimized? What is it that gives me more income and more kind of content to my life? And that is typically being the most fit individual that you can imagine. Fitness and happiness go hand in hand. So I have written a book, Heart Rationality of Feelings and Instincts, about that. And that's the task of feelings, is to guide us toward the greatest fitness. That's what evolution guarantees, or the wisdom of God. So if you want to be the fittest possible, you should be fit yourself and then have the fittest allegiance for your, on your own side. And that should guarantee yourself survival and well-being for the rest of your life, if you manage to keep those causes of action, those things in your life. And you kind of, if you are very fit, you would like to try your forces to something, and that would be most meaningful if you would try it to something that is worthwhile doing. And if you see at the same time work as a, in a way that makes your group stronger, so that you are creating a stronger allegiance and a practice in your group that makes the group stronger and stronger. And so that means playing for justice, so taking a little bit smaller position when you do not deserve it, and taking all the benefit when you deserve it, and taking the benefit wisely, kind of aiming at your own health and health of your social life and health of the practices in the group and in the relationship of your, you and your group to the world at large. And this is achieved by giving each thing its correct place in the whole. In other words, true justice. So this should kind of balance away the inequalities in treatment in rights that are conditional. How to say this? All should be equal under the law, under the rulers. Also the rulers should be equal to all the citizens, but all rights should be conditional, so that if you fulfill certain criterions, for example, do some work that is worth a lot, so then you would get paid for it. And if you harm the system, then you get punished. So this is kind of plus-minus feedback system that optimizes the group, the nation, towards greater benefit for all its parties. It's the usefulness of cooperation together with the usefulness of arranging the cooperation in the most rational way.